Number 13. Drinking or gargling warm water every 15 minutes kills COVID-19. The answer is no, big no. While staying hydrated is very important, these practices do not prevent COVID-19. I mean, it's just salt. The best infection prevention methods for COVID-19 include wearing appropriate personal protective equipment or PPE at work, practicing social distancing, washing your hands, and having good hygiene. Number 12. We can expect the spread of COVID-19 to slow as the weather warms. Generally, coronaviruses survive for shorter periods at higher temperatures and higher humidity than in cooler or drier environments. But it's not yet known whether weather and temperature affect the spread of COVID-19. I mean, look, it's super hot outside, but the numbers still increase. If we're talking about other viruses like those that cause the common cold and flu, which spread more during cold weather months, that doesn't mean it's impossible to become sick with these viruses during other months. There's much more to learn about the transmissibility, severity, and other features associated with COVID-19, and investigations are ongoing. Number 11. COVID-19 can last on surfaces from 48 hours to 17 days. It's not certain how long the virus that causes COVID-19 survives on surfaces. According to the World Health Organization, the virus seems to behave like other coronaviruses. The study suggests that coronaviruses in general may persist on surfaces for a few hours or up to several days. It also varies under different conditions such as type of surface, temperature, or humidity of the environment. After cleaning, wash your hands with soap and water, or use an alcohol-based hand sanitizer or wash the surfaces with soap and water. Avoid touching your eyes, mouth, or nose, please. Number 10. Ventilators are useless and can cause more permanent harm in the long term. It's well known throughout the healthcare community that ventilator-associated lung injury is a risk, particularly with patients who are intubated with ARDS or acute respiratory distress syndrome. But in the medical field, physicians always have to look for alternatives in which the benefits outweigh the risks. For example, here are a few important things to remember. Number 1. In general terms, patients intubated in these settings would almost certainly die without the ventilator. Yes, they need the ventilator or else they would have little oxygen. Number 2. Throughout the years, health experts have learned a great deal about ways on how to reduce the risk of ventilator-associated lung injury. Employing those lessons has significantly reduced the risk. can help prevent or treat COVID-19 infection. That's not true, guys. Those silver preparations do have some natural antibiotic properties, but that's another case. There is no evidence that colloidal silver or other silver-containing products are effective against the COVID-19 virus or any other virus infection. On a side note, silver can be toxic to the brain and kidneys. Number 2. A vaccine for COVID-19 is available. It's sad how people in third world countries like the Philippines are spreading false information about a certain vaccine being effective against corona. People line up in a panic and get shocked by non-professionals. There is no available vaccine to protect against the COVID-19 virus for now, but several vaccine trials are underway in the United States and abroad. Slightly good news is, experts say they are many months away from being ready for widespread use. Just months? That's just amazing, since vaccines and drugs take years to fully develop. Number 1. No to ibuprofen. News has circulated that taking ibuprofen while being infected with COVID-19 will make the condition much worse. Though it is still unclear because there is currently no scientific evidence of patients with negative effects from using ibuprofen while infected with a virus. The World Health Organization says it is consulting with physicians treating the patients. It seems that they have not observed or reported any negative effects aside from the usual ones that limits its use in certain populations. Just in case you're wondering, ibuprofen shouldn't be taken if you have a history of a strong, unpleasant reaction or hypersensitivity to aspirin or other NSAIDs. You have a current or recent stomach ulcer, or you have had one in the past. You have severe heart failure. You have severe liver disease. You are taking low-dose aspirin for the prevention of cardiovascular disease. Anyway, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button and subscribe for more updates regarding COVID-19. By the way, please comment below of any misconceptions you've heard of. See ya!